got a co-op running in front of your place?
Yeah.
You
don't
get that way. You don't get that way.
People like that. I like to fight.
I do too. We have a lady out there called Mrs. Birdwell. And she, I think when she retired, her husband died, she didn't have nothing to do with the bridge. Got nothing to do, so she went down and got her a whole set of Texas law books. That's all she does. Fight him, the city, county, state, it don't matter.
Anything she don't like, she fights.
She fights them. They hate her, too. They hope she'll hurry up and die. Everybody in Mineral Wells likes her, though, in the whole county.
Well, I was living in a town one time, and a little town out in Utah. Well, they had sheep right next to me. Cow, milk cow, and horses across the street. Well, I bought me a 42-year mount to hunt on. Well, when I got my horse, oh no, you can't put him on there. I went to city council and I said, what do you mean I can't put him on there? Cows and horses across the street, sheep right next to me, fence too far. Well, you can't. We're going to start a new order. No more. I said, that's fine with me. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'm going to put him on there. And when all the rest of these go out of town leaving there, I'll be the last one in line.
When the ordinance goes into effect, then you'll remove your ordinance.
I'll lead my horse out of town.
There you go.
They never say another word to me. I'm going to put my horse on.
They do that same way on a carport.
This old bullshit about a very few telling them masters what they can do with their property and stuff. That don't cut out.
We won't put a carport.
When I buy it, pay taxes on it, it's mine. I'll do what I want.
Well, you'll be able to do what you want to do.
Right.
That's not the way it goes, though. Not the way they see it.
If they want something done to it, well, they can buy it and pay taxes on it and do what they want to do.
There you go.
with them because I'm not used to handling them so soft. I usually let mine get a little stiffer. Slick. That slip is just a little too slick. Like in the future, if we have any problems, you know, with it, see how this works out in the future. If we have any problems, I'll probably try to get more accustomed to using it. Right now, I'm trying to get back on track to put them on.
That's fine.
But like you said, the mud is probably a little different than the mud I'm usually used to using.
Probably won't be able to pop it on.
Explain to them and not have any pottery around to actually show it to them.
How do you describe what you do?
Basically what I'm doing, I go like I stick it on and I pull it and shape it, you know, and they go like, yeah, right. And I don't have any pottery at home, any stoneware to show them exactly what I do. I try to get an ordinary cup. They go like, nah, no way. So, it'd be great to have a little presentation to show them exactly how it works. The first time I saw someone do it, I'd be like, I thought you guys glued it on, you know, super glue or something. So that was interesting to see, actually watch somebody do it. Of course, it looks so easy when you first, see them. Yeah, it looks like
funny experience.
Yeah,
man.
You go like, well, I can do that. Somebody say, hey, here you go, try it.
How long have you been doing that?
Right at a year and a half. I'm gonna finish on this board because these are actually a little too soft when I'm, because I hate to pull them out of shape, you know, there's a couple of them kind of warping. Give them a little bit more time. With the humidity like it is outside, it's making it kind of drying process a little slower. That's the first thing I learned. When it rains, you have to roll your handles soft. You know, softer than, so you can start applying them on earlier. And I didn't roll these soft. I mean, it's the first thing I learned, but I didn't do it with this batch of handles. And it's taking a while to dry, so it's actually been a little difficult to put them on.